nerdy. Think I'm just too white and nerdy. Can't you see I'm white and nerdy? Look at me, I'm white and nerdy. I wanna roll with the gangsters, but so far they all think I'm too white and nerdy. Think I'm just too white and nerdy. Think I'm just too white and nerdy. I'm just too white and nerdy. Really, really
first in my class here at MIT. Got skills, I'm a champion of D&D. MC Escher, that's my favorite MC. Keep your 40 out, just have an Earl Grey tea. My rims never spin, to the contrary, you'll find that they're quite stationary. All of my action figures are cherry. Stephen Hawking's in my library. My MySpace page is all totally pimped out. Got people begging for my top 8 spaces. Yo, I know pie to a thousand places. Ain't got no grills, but I still wear braces. I order all of my sandwiches with mayonnaise. I'm a whiz, a minesweeper, I can play for days. Once you see my sweet moves, you're gonna stay amazed. My fingers moving so fast, I'll set the place ablaze. There's no killer app I haven't run. At Pascal, well I'm number one. Do vector calculus just for fun. I ain't got a gap, but I got a soldering gun. Happy Days is my favorite theme song. I can sure kick your butt in a game of ping pong. I'll ace any trivia quiz you bring on. I'm fluent in JavaScript as well as Klingon. Here's the part I sing on.
You see me roll on my Segway. I know in my heart they think I'm white and nerdy. Think I'm just too white and nerdy. Think I'm just too white and nerdy. Can't you see I'm white and nerdy? Look at me, I'm white and nerdy. I like to roll with the gangsters. It's apparent I'm too white and nerdy. Think I'm just too white and nerdy. Think I'm just too white and nerdy. I'm just too white and nerdy. How'd I get so white and nerdy?
I've been browsing, inspecting X-Men comics, you know I collect them. The pens in my pocket, I must protect them. My ergonomic keyboard never leaves me bored. Shopping online for deals on some writable media. I edit Wikipedia. I memorize Holy Grail really well. I can recite it right now and have you ROTFLOL. I got a business doing websites. Websites. Well, my friends need some code, who do they call? I do HTML for them all. Even made a homepage for my doll. Yo, I got myself a fanny pack. They were having a sale down at the Gap. Spend my nights with a roll of bubble wrap. Pop, pop, hope no one sees me getting freaky.
I'm nerdy, indie, extreme, and whiter than sour cream.
I was in AV club and glee club and even the chess team. Only question I ever thought was hard. What do I like, Kirk, or do I like Picard?
Spend every weekend at the Renaissance Fair. Got my name on my underwear. They see me strolling. They laughing. Rolling their eyes cause I'm so.
It was on Friday, February 18th, 1994, at 6:35 p.m. that you arrived in this world, and my life has never been the same. You started out in this world so small, at only 8 pounds, 10 ounces, and 21 inches long. I still recall that day with the same clarity and vividness as when it were here. But you, my son, have been so much more than I could have wondered or expected. You are an absolute joy to have as an infant. I remember coming home at night from work, and would have to get back to work when I got home due to deadlines, so I would put you in a sort of papoose where you would snuggle down on my chest and sleep while I was working. There are times in the past years that I wish I could bundle you up again and hold you close like that. In growing up, you already showed yourself to be very curious and an independent person. You seem to be in awe of the world around you. With your older sister in school already, you could play in your room for hours uninterrupted, making up stories to go along with your favorite toys. And then your youngest sister came along. You have always been a great big brother to her, looking after her, making sure that she was always safe, and sometimes being less than patient with her when she was intentionally being a thorn in your side. I still remember hearing about you escorting her through school on her first day to make sure that she knew how to operate in that new environment and make sure that she knew where she would where she should be when school was over. You fit in so well with your sisters, teasing Jessica almost without mercy and being taunted by Christy. Going over to visit with family was always a joy, as the three of you would occasionally come up with a sort of concert that you would perform for the family members. Getting Christmas trees was always an interesting thing as well, especially when it came to Mommy trying to find you in the tree when it came home. Maybe that's where you got your love of climbing trees, Zacchaeus. Somehow, you developed a complete fascination with dinosaurs. Learning their names, their characteristics, and even knowing how to identify their raw bones. You wanted to be a paleontologist right from the start. People were astonished when that was your response to the standard question, "What do you want to be when you grow up?" Many of them did not know that there was even what that was, and were even more surprised to find out that you did. For many years, we did not know the source from which your keen desire and interest sprang. Then, in the summer of 2007, we went back and visited the St. Louis Museum of Science. Mommy and I both realized in the parking lot that it was here, when you were just over 2 years old, that you had seen the dinosaur exhibit. At that tender young age, you stared in amazement at the giant T-Rex and Triceratops displays, which were animated. When revisited, I recall you saying that you thought it had been a dream. We had no idea that a trip to the museum would shape the course of your life's desire. And we took a trip to Puerto Rico. What a wonderful trip it was. So much so that you wanted to come back for your 18th birthday and climb Mount Breton again. And we did. By the way, how long does it take to get somewhere? As Grandpa in Orlando would say, 2 hours. We could be driving across the island or across the street. We will have to make arrangements to go there again when we're not so pressed for time and really explore the country. I wish my mother, Grammy Amy, were here to see you today. She was such a huge part of your life growing up. If she were still here, I doubt you'd know that you even had legs. I'm sure that you remember the burping contest that you had with her. What times? I know that she would be so very proud of the young man that you have become. I know that I am. And so, with your graduation from high school, you'll be stepping into a whole new chapter of your life. You'll soon be making friends, going to new places, and experiencing new things. Now all you need is a driver's license. Seriously, though, I know that you'll be going on to do great things. Your life is full of potential and your heart full of desire. Make the most of the time that you've been given, for it's the one resource you can never get back. And most important of all, remember that I love you, and Jesus loves you even more.
JD, it feels like it was yesterday when you were in your room playing with all of your toys. And knowing me, I stole them as you turned around. But you always had the time to chase me, pin me to the ground, and pull my hair. Not too hard, but enough for me to give them back. Or the time I was taller than you, and I go, "Aw, look at your little brother." And you chimed in at the exact same time, saying, "No, she is my little sister." But my favorite memory is how you can pick on me every single day, but no one else dare lay a hand on me. You're the brother that I love, the brother I do not deserve, and the brother that I need. Life at school will be different without my main supporter, but I know you'll take the time to come visit me here. And that's all that counts for me. I love you, JD. You're the best. Love, your pesky little sister, Christy.
JD, let me first by beginning to say how truly you are a gift from God. I am so proud to call you my son. Before you were born, the nurses kept saying that I better get my rest now because you were so active, I would need track shoes to keep track of you once you were born. They could never been more wrong. You were so quiet and laid back and just the perfect little baby. You grew up into the perfect little boy with an imagination bigger than yourself. As you got older, you became more creative, and I still have not met anyone with your imagination. I don't know any child who could get more use out of a piece of string and a truck. I'm so proud of you for so many reasons. You have always put a smile on my face, mixed with tears, when you sing. I will never forget you singing in the fifth grade. You shocked everyone when you did the turkey tango with Miss Hall, the principal. You shocked them even more when you dipped her. That same year, you were chosen to be part of the Polk County All-Boys Choir. In elementary, you were always one of the favorite students. You always did what you were told, and you never got into trouble. In kindergarten, and you were probably part of the worst kindergarten class that ever went through Highland City, your teacher, Miss Martinez, always said that if she walked into the class and saw you there, she knew she could make it through another day. Her only complaint was that when you were finger painting, you would only use one finger and you always wanted to wash it. And the elementary teachers always described you as an old man in a little boy's body. You were such a gentleman, and you still are such the gentleman, as I've been told lately. You're just a little older. You always had to have your shirt perfect and your belt just right, not to mention your hair. Out of all the fifth grade, you were chosen to receive a medal from the American Legion of Lakeland for your patriotism and citizenship. How proud we were, knowing how much you love our country. JD, you are a great brother. With your older sister, you are always willing to hang out and play games with her. How many games of Uno did you play? 1, 2 million? With your younger sister, you are always there, even though she knows how to push your buttons. I will never forget her stealing your toys, and you would take off after her in total frustration to get them back. When the two of you got older, the disagreeing began. But when she started school, we learned real fast that we would not have to worry about her. When she got out of the car to cross the street, you grabbed her hand and told her, "No, you don't cross without me," and you walked her across the street. We knew from that point on that you would be her protector, and you always have been. A sure way to get you riled up is for someone to mess with her. I would like to think that you got your love of animals from me, but I can't. I think you got the love from a lot of your family members. I will never forget our time that we spent taking care of Mr. Harthu's animals. My favorite memories are those conversations that we had about the baby ducks and the chicks. Your great-grandfather, who you were named after, would be so proud of you for the way you fought for their little lives. I know that through our conversations, you really got to know your great-grandfather better. Even though you never met him, you were able to share in one of his great loves. JD, you have always been willing to help anyone. You've always been there to help with my book fairs, no matter what the costumes. You have always been there. No matter who asked you to do something, your answer was almost always, "Sure." JD, you believe that if you're going to do something, do it big. In elementary, they had Greek Week. Everyone had to wear a costume. Almost everyone just grabbed a sheet and threw it on to imitate one of the Greek gods, but not you. You had to be a seven-headed dragon. Since then, you have been at Sunrise. You have had a lot of spirit weeks, which you always dressed up for, never the same outfit, and never simple. Then you had all your one-voice costumes. My favorite has had to be the monkey. JD, I am so proud of you for your commitment to pastor and to singing. You're almost always the first one there to class so you can get things done, and you stay to help after if things are needed to be done. Watching you sing still puts a smile on my face, just like when you were in the fifth grade. Your voice has matured and has changed a lot, but I still love to hear you sing. JD, the greatest reason that I am proud of you is your love for God and that you serve God. You have such a tender heart for His will and His ministry. I think the reason you want to help everyone is because of your love for God. It doesn't matter where you are, on the stage or at the top of a tree, you're always singing His praises. JD, you've had the same dream since you were 2 years old. I know with God's help, you will achieve it. Just be patient and get there one step at a time. Enjoy the journey to your dream. Yeah, you, JD. Yeah, you. Did I tell you that I'm proud of you?